don't settle. Don't be desperate.
Yeah.
Know your worth. Everyone, thank you for tuning in to our 7th episode of the Mindset Podcast. Today we will be talking about a very fun topic, which is relationships.
That's right. And before we get started, I just want to, you know, throw a disclaimer out there. We're not love doctors, we're not therapists, we're not counselors.
Almost
we're almost there, you know. You know, my certificate is pending, but
yeah.
You know, anything that we might say, don't, and if you get offended, so sorry. We're speaking straight from the heart, straight from experience. You know, this is what we've been through, so we just want to share that with you. But with that being said, Anthony, you're 19 years old. You're a busy guy. You're in school. You're a realtor with your parents. This podcast. What do you look for in a woman, you know, to be with you, to be in a relationship with you, to just to share that balance with nowadays?
Yeah, you know, Gabe, this is a question that I've been thinking about for a while now. And it's a question that I've asked some of my mentors, actually. And they all said the same thing, is you have to be very careful, right? I think our society sees relationships as a fun thing, you know, couple months thing here and there. It deserves a lot of seriousness. It really does. And what I'm looking for personally for a girlfriend, right? I'm very driven. I'm very motivated. I care about my future.
Very handsome.
And right, thanks, bro. I appreciate that.
Yeah,
I appreciate that. You have to look for someone who's on the same parallel as you are.
Yeah.
What does that mean? You have to look for someone who has the same values as you do, right? You gotta really observe and be careful before you commit to commit to anything, but to a relationship, right? What we're talking about, you gotta be very careful,
yeah.
Right? A girlfriend or boyfriend is a lot of time, as you know, and a lot of energy. You know that, right? You've been in a relationship for 3 years,
yep.
Going strong. You got to be very careful with that,
mm-hmm.
Right? If for me, right, I'm really busy right now in this point in my life. 19 years old. I'm being very selfish. I'm focusing on me first. I'm trying to develop myself, and let me tell you, it's a tricky stage, this 20, 25 year old stage, because you're mature, but you're not quite there yet. There's still some discovering to do within yourself.
For sure.
So personally, I don't think it's the right time for me to have a girlfriend right now. I mean, it has to be the right one,
mm-hmm.
right? But I'm not really looking for one right now. I'm leaving that to later once I work on me for a little bit.
Yeah, I completely see where you're coming from. I mean, I think you said something that was really key, that you're being selfish right now. And I feel like a lot of people might think that that's not okay.
You have to be.
Right now, I mean, I'm in a relationship. I've been in a relationship for 3 years. At that point in time, I mean, we started going out when I was 16. I was obviously young. But, I mean, we've known each other for longer than 6-7 years. So we basically grew with each other, and we kind of knew what our morals, what our values were from day one, you know. And another thing, we didn't look to each other for our happiness. That's what I feel like a lot of people might do nowadays, is that they're seeking happiness in other people, you know, in a boyfriend or a girlfriend. And that's not what you need to be.
Right. That goes to our next topic, which is self-awareness. Right, you gotta understand who you are first. You have to know who you are before you can go out and love somebody else. You need to love yourself first.
Yeah.
If you're not loving yourself first, you're not taking care of you, how do you expect to do that for someone else?
Mm-hmm.
That's just insane. You can't do that. Right? So self-awareness is definitely a big one. And what I've taken away from previous relationships is you don't want to settle.
Yeah.
You need to know your self-worth. You need to know that what you bring to the table is greatness. Like, you are great. You have been chosen to do something very successful with your life that will change millions of people's lives. With that mindset, there's no way you can take anything below that.
Yeah.
Right? Like, don't the message I want to get across is, don't be afraid to be alone. You don't need a girlfriend or a boyfriend, although society is telling you that you do.
Don't be desperate. Yeah.
Don't be desperate. Do you want to go off on that a little bit?
No, for sure. I mean, like you're saying, knowing your self-worth is so important, because again, society's telling us that we need a boyfriend, we need a girlfriend, we need a partner, whatever. But I feel like, you know, everyone is right where they're supposed to be in life. You know, God has a plan for each and every one of us. And I feel like, you know, just that perfect person will come at that perfect time. You know, I always like to say that the right thing at the wrong time is a recipe for disaster. because you can have exactly what you need, but you might not need that for another 5 years. Mm-hmm. You know, and a lot of people like to rush into things because they're looking for that instant gratification, and it's not where they need to be at that point in time.
Right. Just being patient. Like, let things fall into place.
Yeah.
There's no need to be desperate and going out to clubs and looking, trying to find love. Like, mm-hmm. just let it come to you. It will yeah. come, right? It will come. Definitely. And just having that mindset of knowing that you are great.
Yeah.
Like, you have a purpose on this world. So why would you take any less from someone else?
Exactly.
Right? So, and that applies to friends and to boyfriend-girlfriend relationships. And also with that is, you need to let go of your ego, too. Yeah. I feel like a lot of us, myself included, at one point had a very big ego. Like, you think you rule the world,
yeah.
right? And then when people ask you for things, you don't want to do it, right? When you are in a relationship, you're there to serve one another. It works both ways,
Definitely.
Right? So when someone asks you to do this, your girlfriend asks you to do this, you know, let go of that ego and do it for them.
Yeah, yeah. This is something I heard a while back. I forget who said it, but they said that it's. In a relationship, a lot of people like to say it's 50-50, mm-hmm. but it's not. It's 100-100. Once you submit 100% to yourself and to your partner, your relationship will flourish. You know, you just need to put in that effort. I love to cook, for example. Like, I have no problem when my wife, my girlfriend comes home from work and I have dinner ready. You know, that wouldn't have worked 20 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
You know. The wife is supposed to be slaving themselves away in the kitchen.
Yeah.
You know, times have changed, and I feel like it's a fact of respect and for yourself, for your partner, and again, just going back to the ego thing and swallowing your ego and really submitting to your partner.
Mm-hmm. So I want to pick your mind a little bit, right? You've been in a relationship for 3 years. You've known your girlfriend for over 10 years. What do you take away from that? What if you can pick one thing that's the most important thing
yeah.
in a relationship, what would that be?
The number one thing I would say is definitely communication. And this is something I actually lacked going into relationships. Communication is everything. That's pretty much it. I know it sounds cliche, but if you can just say, you know, just communicate with your partner, hey, I'm doing this, I'll be back in 20 minutes. It just clicks, you know.
Absolutely.
It's people forget yeah. the little things, and again, that's huge. Just tell the little things. Just communicate, you know,
the small things.
Obviously on a verbal level, you know, one to one, on a physical level, an emotional level, on a mental level, everything. Mm-hmm. Like, you guys need to be on the same page.
Absolutely,
I think that's the number one.
No,
thing.
You're completely right, Gabe. Communication, of course, is very important, and also another big one is trust.
Yeah,
right. Trust, man. Gosh, trust, and this applies not only to relationships, this applies to everything in life,
yeah.
to all kinds of relationships.
Definitely.
To in your work, like, if you don't have trust for the other person, everything falls apart. Mm-hmm. It's like a balloon, you pop it, there's no trust, there's
yeah.
nothing there,
yeah.
right? They create so many more problems,
yeah.
right? So, again, when you're looking for a girlfriend, when you're looking for a boyfriend, look for someone that has the same values as you have and someone that you feel that you can trust.
Yeah.
And you'll learn it. You'll go through some things. You'll figure out who you can trust, who you can't.
Yeah, trust doesn't come overnight.
Yeah, oh, definitely. It takes years to build.
It takes years, and unfortunately, people have gone through things that they lose that trust, or they have trust issues or whatever the case is, but it's definitely a process,
mm-hmm.
you know? Everything in life, you know?
It takes time. You can't rush relationships,
yeah.
any kinds of relationships, right?
Yeah.
So definitely something that you build towards.
So I think another vital part to relationships is people nowadays feel like their partner needs to complete them. And that's not the way it's supposed to be. You know, you're supposed to find happiness within yourself, and then you guys just complement each other.
Mm-hmm.
You can't find, I know so many people that there feels some emptiness inside and they're looking for someone else to complete that and to fill that void, but their relationship is not going to flourish with that because they need to find that within themselves first. And then once they get that, then they can complement their partner, their boyfriend, their girlfriend, and then that's when they grow with each other.
Right. Having a girlfriend, boyfriend should be an addition to you.
Yeah.
And vice versa, like, you both help each other out
yeah.
on your journey to success.
You guys are two individual people on two individual paths, you know, sharing one life together. you know,
yeah. And grow and with each other.
Growing with each other. You guys should be able to improve each other and, you know, push each other to
Absolutely.
Be better.
Absolutely.
You know, I wake up every morning wanting to be better for those who I love. Mm. You know, that's where I find my motivation. Mm. You know.
Yeah, and let me ask you a question. With your girlfriend in particular, if you don't mind sharing, you're very busy, right? You have your company, you're doing the podcast, you're in school, you're learning, right? You're mm-hmm. focusing on you yeah. to some extent. How's the dynamic with you and your girlfriend when, let's say, you guys are out at dinner and your client calls you in the middle of dinner? Do you pick it up? And if you do, does she get mad? Does she understand? Is she supportive of you?
It's actually funny you say that, because that actually happened a couple of days ago. We were having lunch and... yeah, one of my clients called me and I had to take it. I was like, look, babe, I have to take this. We got to talk about something. And she was completely okay with it. And I think that's something very important that you should look for, you know, especially in what I've been doing with my business, with my lifestyle. I'm so busy, and she knows exactly what that entails, you know, and we know exactly, we balance each other out. Mm. And she was completely supportive in that situation. She knows exactly what I had to do. Because she knows what the end goal is. She knows what mm-hmm. the end result is, you mm-hmm. know? And if that means, you know, sacrificing 5 minutes for me to take a call real quick, then she's all for it.
Dude, let me tell you, that is crucial, man. That is crucial. Having a girlfriend that supports you, who sees your vision. And she's mm-hmm. she's there to help you, Definitely. Right? There's nothing more important than that. And look, to wrap things up, for our viewers and our listeners today, don't settle. Don't be desperate.
Yeah.
Know your worth. Know that you're great. Know that you're here for a purpose. And whoever and whenever you decide to be with someone, know that they need to be at the same level, have the same mindset that you have. Don't let anyone bring you down. And just be patient. Things will come. Your girlfriend, your boyfriend will come. Yeah. Please, please, please don't be desperate. And please know your worth.
Yeah, just stay the course.
Yep.
And for all you single ladies out there, my boy Anthony is single and ready to mingle. So...
yeah. Hit me up whenever, guys.
Hit him up. He's a busy guy.
Open line.
You know, he'll make time.